Hey everyone, if your CPU cooler isn't working out well for you anymore, or you simply fancy to change to maybe go in from air cooling to liquid cooling, you might be wondering if you can change the cooler without removing your motherboard, because after all, that basically is like building a new computer. You've got to unhook all the power cables, take out your motherboard and everything else, and it's a complete pain. And the short answer is yes, most of the time you can simply change your cooler without removing your motherboard, but there are one or two key things you need to be aware of. And that's because many times a CPU cooler, whether it's an all-in-one cooler or an air cooler, you need a different backplate, which is the metal thing that goes on the back of the motherboard, and then your actual cooler clips onto that. So where you've got your screws or your bolts that actually go through and mount to your CPU cooler, that's what they actually mount to, is the backplate. And the thing is, what some people do is they remove the old CPU cooler and then the actual backplate falls out and then it falls down the bottom of their case or something like that, which of course is a complete pain, because if you can't then easily get to that, you might actually need to remove your motherboard then to actually get the backplate and put it back. So what I'd always suggest doing is when you're changing your CPU cooler, you hold on to the backplate if at all possible. And the reason I say that is most cases actually have a little slot, an outline on the back where you can actually access the motherboard backplate. If you don't have that, obviously it's a little bit harder. You just need to make sure that maybe you tip your computer slightly forward, so when you remove your old CPU cooler, the backplate isn't going to disappear or something like that. Because ultimately when you put your new cooler on, that might actually knock the backplate out. So it is really hard, but that is something to be aware of, is you don't want to accidentally have the backplate fall off or something like that. And that's why many people actually start off building by putting their motherboard on a table, because that keeps the backplate in place. But obviously if it's already in situ in your case, you can't do that, but that is worth knowing. The other thing to know is that sometimes with some coolers, you do actually need to change that backplate. You can't keep the stock one. And in that case, of course, it depends entirely on your case. If you do have that slot at the back where you can actually access that backplate, then great. It's not a problem. You don't need to move your motherboard. You simply remove your old cooler, remove the old backplate, put the new backplate on, and then mount the new cooler, and that will work absolutely fine. But if you don't have that slot, you will unfortunately need to remove your entire motherboard to change your CPU cooler. So I would look at your case and just make sure it has that, because most of them do, but I have seen one or two that don't have that. And if you don't have that, then changing your CPU cooler will be a little bit more annoying. And that pretty much wraps up this video. If you've got any questions, please let me know down in the comments. But other than that, thank you for watching this video. Please click the thumbs up button if you enjoyed it, and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.